Hey everyone, welcome back to episode 8 of our Let's Play series. In our last episode, we built this lovely horse area that is behind me. I had a lot of fun building it and it turned out really nice, so that's great. In this episode, we are going to work on a pumpkin and melon farm. I have the layout all planned out, and so if you caught that in the last episode, then woo! I didn't point it out in the last episode, but it was there. But yeah, so hopefully that'll turn out alright. If you enjoy these... Oh, okay, wow, what am I doing? If you enjoy these videos, make sure to like and leave a subscribe. And now we shall stare into my face as I, like, do that. I think I was trying to, like, I don't know, move around. It turned out a little weird. Like, look at my face. But yeah, anyway, that's all we have planned for today. I don't really have much other stuff planned because the pumpkin and melon farm is going to probably take the entire episode length to build. It's huge and it's a pain in the butt. But let's get started. So I did add some, lampposts off camera. I finally came up with a design I wanted for them, which is like cool. It's kind of similar to a design I've done before in like some of my other worlds, but I kind of switched it up a bit by adding trapdoors on the top. And I also made a path towards the village just to, you know, help me out a bit when I go over there to like trade and get levels. Plus, I do want to build more in this area. Like, there is so much space to work with. We'll have to come up with some ideas. I have like a whole list of ideas. I just don't know when I'm actually going to build them. I think in the next episode, I'll either do an oxalotto area or a cat house. Anyway, let's walk over to our pumpkin farm layout. Like I said, if you saw this in the last episode, nice. I ran past it when trying to find horses. I didn't point it out, though, because I was like, well, I'll learn to see it anyway. So yeah, I got most of this stuff in there already. I honestly don't know what I went back to the storage area for. Let's see, I'm getting iron. Okay, yeah, the buckets. I forgot about the buckets. You need the buckets. And the bones for bone meal. I, like, just recorded this and was like, wait, what am I doing? And we also have to feed the dog before we go, you know? Otherwise, that's cruel. Very, very cruel. And this time, I remembered to drink water before doing the voiceover. And every time I pass the pigs, I hear a zombie. Like, I feel like I'm going crazy. There's no zombie over there, and there's no caves. I've checked. There's nothing. Absolutely nothing. I'm going insane with that. Although, there is a big cave over by the beach, so maybe it's from that, but I don't know. It's like with the spider in the last episode. It's, like, not there, but you hear it. Like, what is going on with that? Anyway, we shall get started with our lovely farm. Yeah, and I had to, like, check over here to see if there's a drowned or something. Like, I'm going crazy with this. Like, the stupid mobs keep making noise, but it's like, there's nothing there. Okay, yeah, I gotta switch my stuff around. Get the tools I need out in the hot bar, and then, yeah. And then get the stuff I need, the observers, pistons, redstone, all that fun jazz. And I'm going to speed up just the process of this, because, like, it'd be too long if I showed all of it. But I will include this just in case anyone's like, hey, I want to do that in their own bedrock world. This is probably, like, maybe not the most efficient farm, but it's better than, like, any other pumpkin or melon farm I've done. The last one I did, I followed a tutorial and it was like so difficult to build. And I was like, okay, the next time I make one, it's gonna be something a little more easier. And this was like the easiest way, so. Yeah, basically put them like this and then you get some water in the middle and I'll put a minecart with a hopper underneath both sides of those. Just because then, yeah, you know, in case they fall on there, they can still get picked up. So, yeah, I was, like, trying so hard to figure it out. I was like, okay, how do I want to do this? Because I just kind of, like, I winged it. I only built the building in survival, in creative. So I didn't actually do the farm mechanics in creative. I probably should have, but I didn't. So yeah, you just gotta watch me struggle for 5 minutes trying to figure it out. Struggled so much with this part. I was like, okay. But I got the rails out, and then, yeah, I have the torches, which are, yeah. I was like, what did I do? Like I said, I just recorded it, but I forgot already. And it looks like it's nearing nighttime, so I'll definitely have to go to bed soon. Yeah, I was looking for wood, I think, because I didn't have enough chests to put down there. So I got, jungle wood and all that fun jazz. And I think after that I still didn't have enough, so I don't know. I don't remember. But yeah, I got the torches. Oh, I didn't even have the torches before. I must have grabbed them then. Okay. But yeah, I got torches, I have to get, chests, and spoiler alert, I have to go back to get more wood for the chests. I definitely underestimated how many chests I need for, the hopper collection system. And then I had to grab a bed, because obviously I did not have a bed over there, and I was not about to go back and forth every time I needed to sleep. So yeah, after we sleep, we can get back to work. Yeah, I love how, I tried going to sleep in the storage area. I was like, oh, no, not nighttime yet. And then I go to sleep by the pumpkin farm, and it's like, okay, yeah, it's nighttime. Minecraft. The joys. Oops, I accidentally tore up the top part there. So yeah, we're just gonna put a torch in there, and then we're gonna set down the power rail. That way the minecart can go back and forth, you know. If you made a farm before, then you know. Yeah, and this part I struggled with so bad. Just this little part right here. Cause I realized on this end the torches made the pistons do that. And it took me a few seconds to figure out, okay, why is it doing that? It was because of the torch. So yeah, I was like, wait, why isn't it doing it on the other end? Well, the other end's not a piston. It's a, observer. So yeah, I was only doing it with the pistons, and I was like, great. But then I figured it out eventually, so you'll see in a few here what I did. Honestly, it just felt like rocket science trying to get this done. I was like, why? It's like, yeah, I don't know why redstone farms have to be, so difficult. It's like, why can't they be simple? Why can't redstone be easy? It's not easy. It's never easy. Yeah, and then I do the same thing on the other side, obviously. There's not really much I can say during this part. I'm just like, okay, let's watch me utterly goof this up. I mean, it works out in the end, so I guess, you know, I didn't goof it up too bad. Of course, my cat almost jumped on my phone. Please do not jump on my phone while I'm trying to do a voiceover, bro. So yeah, I like had to dig out parts for where the hoppers go, and then you know the hoppers and the chest and all that fun stuff. The collection area. Basically, this build's gonna like have the collection area downstairs, and then it's gonna have an upper story where I'll have like all the stuff stored. And I'll probably also add like a little workstation and a bed up there too. Because I mean, I have to have a bed in like almost all my builds. That way, in case I have to sleep there for the night, it's like, okay, there you go. I'm like watching my show while doing this, and it's just like so emotional. It's like, oh my gosh, I don't even like this ship, and it's just like so emotional. Okay, what am I doing right now? I was not paying attention. I'm so bad. I'm like, yeah, let's make Minecraft videos, but I'm not gonna pay attention while doing a voiceover. I think at this part I'm adding the water. Because I still need the water in the center. Because obviously that's probably where most of the pumpkins and melons are gonna go. And then I also had to put the carts underneath. Okay, now I add back in the dirt and then I add in the water. And I like totally goofed up on the water the first time around when I added it. So it's gonna look a little funky. But then I fix it so it's like fine, you know. Okay, this show is like seriously too emotional. I probably shouldn't watch stuff while like trying to do a voiceover. I had to turn it down so it wouldn't like, I don't know, make noise. Like, I forget what episode or video I was recording, and my auto captions picked up the stuff from the TV show. I was like, oh wait, I never said that. That was the TV show. But yeah, as you can see, like when I put the water in there, it didn't like go all the way down. So I was like, okay, how are we gonna fix that? And obviously, this, what I'm doing right here, didn't work. So, like, yeah, you'll see what I do to fix it in a bit here. Because then I also added it again, but again, like, my pumpkins and melons, like, chopped down. They just didn't go to the end. Because, you know, I goofed it up. I'm like, yeah, I probably should have, like, done the redstone components, like, in my creative world, but oh well. Yeah, now I'm gonna dig down just to have like the little collection area. It's kind of wonky because I didn't think it all the way through. I probably should have, but oh well. You know, sometimes you just gotta wing it. Let's see, I gotta get my crafting table out. And gotta get some ladders. And then get some trap doors. That way I can cover up the big gaping hole in the floor. You know, you always gotta do that with your Minecraft buildings. Like if there's a big gaping hole, place a trap door over it. So yeah, I've got all the way down there, get the ladder going. And then get the trap doors on. Yeah, I like totally goofed up on that part too. Oops. Okay, so yeah, I like added the other side. I was like, if I included that, this video would have been like an hour long. Yeah. So yeah, now we're gonna add cauliflower seeds. I'm making one side pumpkins and then the other side is going to be melons. That way they're kind of somewhat organized. Because, like, in my other world I have, like, I did not separate them by, like, pumpkins and melons. I just kind of threw them all in the same bit. And then, yeah, it's like, they're not organized. They just come out whenever. But, yeah, this keeps it somewhat organized. So, that's nice. And I, like, literally love this, like, little foliage add-on. Like, seriously, look at that. You can tell the difference from the stem. Like, the stem has little pumpkins on it, and then you'll see when I do the melons, like, I have, like, little melons on them on the other side. Like, it's so cute. I didn't have, like, the, texture pack dip on it. Yeah, here's where I realized I goofed up majorly on the water part, as you can see. I was like, wait, that's not working. And so, yeah, I had to, like, take out the water, and then I had to grab the pumpkin because it doesn't reach all the way down there. But then I realized that I can just add more hoppers, like, yeah. So that's what we do. I'm not sure if I did it right after this or not, but that's what I do. I just add more hoppers over there. Okay, it looks like I'm going over to get more iron and stuff. And for some reason, my game was just, like, really laggy while, like, recording this, so hopefully that doesn't be too bothersome. It was kind of annoying while I was recording it, but then, like, I don't know. It's not, like I said before, there's just not much I can do about it. So yeah, I got my hoppers, and now we're going to add them down in there, and then I'm going to do that on the other side before I even add the seeds to the other side. And then I realized, oh crap, I have a bird up there. I can't get the chest open. Oops. Yeah, and I'm gonna do it to the other side too in a second here. I kind of forgot that I had to do it to the other side, so I only got the four hoppers, and I was like, oh yeah, I have another side, huh? So yeah, I got those hoppers and then add those in there. I think one of these episodes, we're gonna try to go raid an ocean monument, because I really wouldn't mind some sponges. Like, I was thinking of that while filming this. It's like, we should do that. Maybe later on when I have a little bit better gear and stuff. Plus, I don't even know where one's at. I'd either have to get a map from a villager, or I'd have to look on the seed map. So yeah, I got that added in, and then I do the melons on the other side. So hopefully with this farm, we'll be able to just have pumpkins and melons to go trade with the villagers. I think either in the next episode, or at least in the next few episodes, I'm gonna make a better crop field. That way, like, you know, we just have more crops growing. Which right now, I only have potatoes growing in one field. So it's like, yeah, I kind of gotta get stuff in other fields, too. I mean, not that I have other fields, I just need other crops. It's, like, honestly kind of annoying how the pistons go when I'm passing fields, but that's how it works. But yeah, as you can see, there's like little melons on the stem, and it's like so cute. Like, I love this better foliage texture pack, which I do have it in the description in case anyone's like, hey, I want to do that on my world. You know, I try to have all my stuff linked down below, so. But yeah, I think I'm done with the redstone mechanics for now. Next up will be the build, but yeah, we got like the collection system, and we already got a good chunk of stuff in there. I mean, there's like, I forgot how many pumpkins. I was like 8, and then there's 4 melon slices in that one. So yeah, I guess it's like time to move on to the build. That's gonna be fun. It's gonna be very magnificent. Okay, so we finished our build, and I was heading back to the storage room for a shovel to do the floor, because the diamond shovel I have is just too fast for that, and I don't want to, like, mess up anything. But then I realized I had iron and sticks over at the pumpkin farm. So I was like, okay. So yeah, let's just run back over there. And as you can see, this thing is, like, ginormous. Like, yeah. It was a very big pain to build. But it honestly, it turned out really nice. I'll decorate like the inside and stuff off camera and then add the path and whatnot. That way it's like all there. Right now we're just gonna do the floor because I figured that's like an on-camera thing we can do. And I forgot I had this creeper hole right here. I think off camera a creeper blew up and then I was like, okay, let's just cover that up. I probably should have filled it in too, but oh well. So yeah, I just did acacia flooring because I just went with the build. And I didn't have enough spruce wood with me, and I didn't feel like running back to the storage room. But I think the flooring looks nice, it fits. I honestly built this building in orange because it just overall fit. Yeah, and then I was like, oh crap. The ladder fell apart. But that's alright, it was an easy fix. It's not like, oh my god, so difficult, I have to take an hour to fix it. Like, no, it took a second. But yeah, this was like, I don't know, it turned out nice. I like it. I'll have to add the storage upstairs off camera too. Hopefully we can get a lot of pumpkins and melons with this. I do have my cake speed up, so hopefully. I only turned it up since, like, I had to turn my cheats on to, like, film the time lapses. It's like, yeah, I don't plan on cheating, but, like, I need the cheats on so, like, you know, my other thing can cheat and, like, go on creative. But yeah, it's like, I can't turn up the tick speed unless, like, the cheats are on, so. But yeah, I like having the tick speed up because then the stuff just, like, goes faster. Crops grow faster, trees decompose faster. It's easier. And I honestly wasn't too sure if I had enough wood for this part. I was like, oh my god, don't make me go chop down trees. But I had enough wood, so it was fine. I even like counted. I was like, okay, one, two. And yeah. Ladders fixed, got the flooring in, got our farm working. It's turned out nice. So thank you all for watching and sticking through this very tough process of building a farm. There probably will be more farms in this world, just not right away. They're very tiring to build. Anyway, thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, you know, consider leaving a like, maybe subscribe, you know, if you want to. But again, thank you everyone, and I hope you all have a good day or night or whatever time it is over there. Anyway, bye everyone.